Hey everyone, how's it going? It's Uncle Donkey. So, I decided to do Skyrim. There was a Steam sale today, and I picked up Skyrim on the cheap. So, anyway, probably by the time this video goes up, the sale will be over, but it only cost me $8 to get Skyrim, and I think that is worth it. So anyway, I have had to make some major sacrifices to get Skyrim to run on my PC and also record as well. I have to reduce all the graphics settings to minimum, and I'm having to play in a windowed screen. But if I play in full screen, the game crashes every time I fast travel somewhere. And if I have the graphics settings any higher, the game just gets really laggy and choppy, and it doesn't work very well. But anyway, I guess I should explain some things really fast. I decided I wanted to be kind of like a mage kind of character, so I'm going to be joining the College of Winterhold. And also, just a lot of people have been asking me to do Skyrim. I have gotten more requests to do Skyrim than any other non-RuneScape game ever in history. So I decided to, you know, try my best to appease you guys. I don't have a very good PC. If a PC can barely run Skyrim on minimum graphic settings while recording, you know, it's not the best. But anyway, she wanted me to cast a firebolt spell in here. I did not have a firebolt spell, so I had to go to Whiterun and buy one. But anyway,
well, I'll lead you across the bridge. Once you're inside, you'll want to speak with Mirabel Irvine, our master wizard.
Anyway, I'm just joining the College of Winterhold here. I guess the reason I wanted to do this is just, you know, if you're a mage, it kind of figures that you'd want to do the mage stuff first. Also, I really hate the starting of the main quest line. If you want it, yeah, just go, lead on. I understand that. What are you doing? Oh, never mind. I guess she's fine, but yeah, she's kind of annoying, taking forever. But, yeah, I hate the main quest line because it takes about an hour until you actually get to do anything in the main quest line, because you have to, like, talk to the Arl and then go kill a dragon and then talk to some more people and do a whole bunch of crap. Anyway, I really hate the main quest line. I'll just say that. I cannot stand it. At least the first couple hours of it. Then it gets to get, you know, vaguely interesting. And I just did the Fighters Guild Companions on the Xbox playthrough that I'm doing. Well, I shouldn't say it playthrough. I'm playing it on the Xbox as well. I'm doing a two-handed character on there. I just finished the Companions on him. So I didn't really want to do the Companions again when I just finished them. So that's why I decided to do the Winterhold College. Also, you know, I'm a mage and it kind of makes sense. But anyway, now that she finally let us there, I know you can just run past her, but I wanted to take the time to explain a few things just while we're walking. So anyway, this is the Mage's Guild. He's the Archmage, Savos Eren. I have played this game so many times. It's like Oblivion. I have a ton of knowledge, except this game I've played way more recently than Oblivion, so I guess the memory is a little more fresh. And he is a shady character. For those of you who have not played this game, I won't talk about him anymore. But anyway, we talked to Mirabel. I was told to come see you.
Another new student. I'm surprised at how many of you there are lately. Well, first you'll need these. While you're not required to wear them, you may find them more to your liking than your current...
And she gives you novice robes, I believe. Which I already have.
Wonderful. Please follow me.
Except she gave me novice robes of destruction, and I'm not sure what kind of robes I have. I believe it's just novice robes. Magicka regenerates 50% faster. So this one is the exact same as the ones I have, except it also is destruction spells cost 12% less to cast. So we're going to do that. And the novice hood. Obviously, robes, they give no armor. However, they're usually very beneficial for magic. Because spells are very expensive, and Magicka regenerates slowly, unless you're wearing robes, which obviously help out with those things. So she's going to take us on a short tour and just tell us a whole bunch of stuff that you probably already know if you've ever played this game before. But you have to go through it. It's just the way it is. But luckily, the Mage's Guild isn't like the main quest line. It does stand away from her, so she's not interrupting me. Luckily, if you turn your back to her, she's not as loud. But yeah, the Mage's Guild does not take as long to get started as the main quest line. I don't understand why games do that. It seems like almost every game's main quest line has like an hour or two of kind of like just tutorial stuff and storyline to go through before you ever actually get to do anything. And it would be great if games could find some way to incorporate going through a bunch of boring storyline into actual fun gameplay, because it just kind of puts you out of it. Like, the first time you ever play Skyrim, it's cool, but ever after that, every single time you play through Skyrim again, it's just so boring that you have to go through the first hour of, you know, just random stuff before you ever actually get to go adventuring in dungeons and killing things, which is what we all bought this game to do, really. But anyway, she's going to show us to our quarters, which are in here. The Hall of Attainment. So there is a lot of stuff to do around the college. A fair amount of the people inside the college, like just the students and teachers and stuff, have side quests that you can do as well. So that's pretty cool. All of them obviously have side quests for when you reach like level 100 in a magic skill for the master spells, which I've never done before. It's one of the few things in this game I've never done before. Another thing I've never done before in this game is completed every Daedric quest. I'm not sure why, I've just never completed all of them on one character before. Anyway, she says these are our quarters. We're not going to be staying here. Some nice alchemy ingredients there that I'll take. I obviously will be doing quite a bit of alchemy, or potioning as I call it. It is one of the slowest skills in this game to train. Potioning just takes a very, very long time to level up. But I'll be working on that. But anyway, yeah, I want to mainly focus on destruction and I'm not sure what else. That's the main skill I want to focus on for now. Not really worry about anything else. Smithing, obviously. It's always cool to be able to make really good armor. Smithing is like one of my favorite skills in this game, even though it as well is quite slow to train. Until you get the Transmute Ore spell, which makes smithing very easy, but we'll get into that later on if I do end up like doing a full playthrough of this game or something, which I kind of want to do. I'm tempted. I am tempted. By the way, let me know how the mic quality sounds. I did get a new mic, so that happened as well. I don't know why I waited so long. Okay, I get it. Okay, so she's finally done. Now we can really get started in the less boring parts of the Mage's Guild. I shouldn't call it the Mage's Guild, it's technically the College of Winterhold. They don't have a Mage's Guild and a Fighter's Guild like they did in Oblivion and Morrowind and every other Elder Scrolls game. We were just beginning. Please, stay and listen. Okay.
So, as I was saying, the first thing to understand is that magic is, by its very nature,
this guy is awesome. Sargo.
Unless you can control it, it can and will destroy you.
I will destroy you unless you shut up.
We all understand that very well. We wouldn't be here if we couldn't control magic.
I think all these guys give you side quests as well. I'm not sure if you have to actually start the official Mage's Guild first quest before you can get them, though.
What I'm talking about is true control, mastery of magic. It takes years.
I guess I can't just straight up talk to him yet. I have to wait for him to finish talking to these students.
What are we waiting for? Let's get started.
I love Khajiit accents in this game, by the way. I don't know why. Maik the Liar has the coolest accent in the entire game. But this guy has a pretty cool accent as well.
Just arrived here. You've no idea what any of us are capable of. I think it's a chance to show you what we can do.
You've been quiet so far. What do you think we should do?
I'm not really sure what to think.
I admire your restraint, but there are times when you must make decisions, even without all the facts. Rely on
instinct. I disagree, sir.
We're all pretty good at this, right? Let's just give it a chance. What's the worst that could happen?
Well, one of us could die.
All right,
that wouldn't be very good. Hopefully the game volume isn't really low. I have had problems with volume in general, but I did do about like 10 test recordings before I actually started, and the last couple turned out pretty well. I hope he actually gives me a ward, because I don't have one yet. I don't know any ward spells. Oh, cool, he gave me a ward spell. So, wards are fairly useless. They're like a shield for magic. But in general, when you're fighting enemies that are magic users, you don't want to be using shields against them. You want to just... well, if you're a fighter class... Would this be an alter... What? Illusion, maybe? No? What is this in? Oh, restoration. Duh. Anyway... As I was saying, if you're fighting enemies that are magic users, you don't want to be putting up shields against them. You want to be getting up close and killing them as fast as possible. Especially if you're playing on a higher difficulty. I'm only playing on Adept, which is the one in the middle. the medium difficulty, which is good enough for me, because I'm not gonna lie, I'm not amazing at this game or anything, so I'm not gonna even try master. So he's gonna shoot me. Blocked it with the ward. Again, that's not really a spell I'll probably ever use again in my entire life.
I think perhaps we're ready to begin exploring some of these various applications of magic throughout this.
So he's going to give us a quest called Under Sarthal, hopefully soon, which starts the main storyline for the Mages Guild, because you find an interesting object down underneath Sarthal. But we'll get into that once we find it. Okay, so now I believe we just go straight to Sarthal, so yeah, we just get right into it here. So I'll try out the Firebolt spell. I never really liked this spell very much until I get to a higher destruction level, so I might just stick with the flames. They're pretty cool as well. But anyway, we might have to journey to Sarthal, because I've never... Yeah, we're going to have to run to Sarthal. Luckily, I have discovered a location that's pretty close to it already when I was running to Winterhold, because unfortunately, I used the wagon in Whiterun to travel to Dawnstar, and then after that I had to run to Winterhold, because you can't like use a wagon to travel there or anything, unfortunately. But anyway, I remember the first time I ever played this game, I also did the Winterhold Mages College first. I'm not sure why. I heard like one of the random NPCs around me saying, oh, you should join the Mages College in Winterhold, and I'm like, yeah, I'll do that. So I went to Winterhold and joined the college. And I was only like level 5 or something, and let's just say in Sarthal there's a very high level enemy that you have to fight, and he killed me many times. But yeah, and I was playing on a lower difficulty too, like apprentice or something like that, and I just could not get past it. But of course that's back when I didn't know the ins and outs of this game as much. I remember the first time I ever played Skyrim, like I literally sat down and played for about 14 hours straight, because I was like, holy crap, this game is amazing. But yeah, let's just say I had very good first impressions of this game. Also, I have very low health, so that's why I'm being so careful descending this cliff. If I fall from a high distance, I will die. Like, if I just jumped off from that ledge here, I would have hit the ground and died. So that's what happens when you have really low health. And there's a chest over here. Huh. I guess I forgot about that one. Anyway, Magicka potions, luckily, I'm not going to really need them, even though I'm like a mage character, because I'm going to be using skill points in destruction, which is going to make my destruction spells cheaper, and then also hopefully wearing armor that will, again, help with the Magicka regeneration. So this is a silver ore vein. Silver ore is very important. Silver and gold, those are the best ways to train your smithing. When this game first started, you could just make iron daggers and train smithing very, very fast, but that has been nerfed. So now the best way to train it is by making jewelry, because jewelry has a high gold value, and how much smithing experience you get depends on the value of an item. So it looks like I arrived here too early, and the others aren't here yet. So let's wait a while. I think they don't arrive for like a day or something, and yeah, this game is somewhat realistic, in the sense that other people won't just teleport straight to a location sometimes. They'll actually take the time to travel there. And I was just too fast. I was too fast for them. Hopefully they're here now and we can enter in Sarthal. Yep, there's Raylina. There's Tolfdir. Okay, I'm ready. Let's go in.
You stay close to me while we're inside.
Oh, it won't be safe. Believe me, it will not be safe. But anyway, even if my game volume is too low, luckily I did put the subtitles on so you guys won't be completely lost, but... Okay, it says follow you, let's go. Are you gonna go in here? Or do I have to... do you have to follow me? Okay, finally, I think you got the message. I don't know where the other apprentices are. There's supposed to be two others coming with us, but... Jizargo, who is one of the best followers in the game, we won't get him till later, but as soon as I get a chance, I do want to get Jizargo, because he's a very, very powerful follower. Why are you not so sure we should be? You're like the man who's all...
You here too, eh?
I hope all awesome.
Magic is... No offense. No. There's no chance. Our ancestors should be allowed to rest in peace.
I guess you do get a side quest from him later, but I guess he won't offer that while we're on this quest.
There might be gold somewhere in here.
Why are you worried about gold? We're in an awesome ruin, and you're worried about gold? I don't have any more questions. So he wants us to find enchanted items, which could end badly. I'm not sure where I have to find someone. I believe that someone that I need to find is going to be upstairs. Did I see a chest up here? I think I did. Nope, that's not a chest. Never mind, false alarm. Probably. Maybe she's not upstairs. I don't know. I don't even know where I'm going right now. Oh, don't worry. There is magic down in this place. For one, I'm down here and I'm pretty magical, so that's something. But, yeah, the Mage's Guild also has, in my opinion, the best quest in the game. Or my personal favorite quest in the game, at least. It's probably a little bit biased just to call it the best because it's my favorite, but we'll get into that one later on. It's also a quest that I might struggle with quite a bit at a low level. I didn't get myself stuck down here, did I? I really hope I didn't do that. That would be bad. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Yeah, I can't go through here. I think I very well might be stuck. Remember, there is one place in the main quest line where you can get completely stuck and you can't get out, and I had... Oh, never mind. I found a way out. But yeah, there is one area in the main quest line where you can get stuck to the point where it's impossible to get out and you just have to reload. And that was never fixed with the patch or anything, so... We'll get into that later, though. How do I get over there? Uh-oh. I don't even know what I'm doing right now, guys. I didn't remember it being such a puzzle just to get to this lady that I need to talk to. Let's go over here. Okay, I think I got it figured out now. Get out of my way. Well, I thought you were after gold, man. Gotta go get yourself some gold. Get rich.
Don't touch anything.
I thought Arneel was a woman.
What?
Perhaps not. Or a really bald, manly sounding woman.
Right? You don't want to damage anything.
I'm sorry. I'm skipping over text. It's just a bad habit. It's hard to resist. So, enchanted rings. And you can actually sell these too afterwards, which is kind of nice for some starting gold if you're a bit low on the cash. In my inventory, I will admit, let's see. If you go down into all and you see I have quite a bit of stuff, you'll notice I have quite a lot of high level soul gems. I will admit that I did hit up the secret chest in Dawnstar before I actually did anything else. I will admit that. But yeah, that was like the first thing I did when I got to Dawnstar before I headed off for Winterhold. I nabbed the secret chest. There wasn't anything good in there. I mean, there's a couple of decent enchanted items, a whole bunch of soul gems.
Is everything all right?
But yeah, it's not really glitch because it's put in the game. But yeah, every time I go in Dawnstar, I always hit up the chest there. I think it respawns like once a week or something. You could put it on. I mean, what else would you do with an amulet? So let's put on this amulet. First, get rid of these boots. I don't need those. Sarthal amulet. So it makes spells 3% less Magicka to cast, which isn't really all that useful, but. Anyway, Tolfdir's gonna just go in here because he's a man.
Well, this is
it is highly unusual. Before I forget, I'm gonna go into destruction. No, not conjuration. Destruction. Get this perk. This is very useful. Dual casting a destruction spell overcharges the effects to an even more powerful version. So that means when you use the spell with both hands, it becomes more powerful. And this is the best perk in the game if you're a magic caster. It basically means if you dual cast destruction spells, it will make your enemies staggered, which basically means you can stun lock them, which makes this game very easy sometimes. But, let's see, fire spells. I can't get this one yet, but I'm going to be as soon as I possible. Yeah, just completely getting a ton of perks in destruction. Rune Mass, that's not very useful, but Apprentice level destruction spells for half Magicka. I guess I need 90 or 25 destruction to do that, so I can't quite get that one yet, but I can now do this. Boom. So, yeah, my spells will just be a little bit stronger now. I think I'm going to stick with the flames, though, because I'm not going to have the Magicka to use that the next level spell, just because I don't have the perk that makes it cost half as much yet. But anyway, my flames are a bit stronger now. So, let me guess, Draugr are going to pop out of the walls.
I do hope you know what you're doing with those flames. Hold, mage, and listen well. Know that you have set in motion a chain of events that cannot be stopped. Judgment has not been passed, as you had no way of knowing. Judgment will be passed on your actions to come, and how you deal with the dangers ahead of you. This warning is passed because the Psijic Order believes in you. You, mage, and you alone, have the potential to prevent disaster. Take great care, and know that the Order is watching.
And that was a mage from the Psijic Order that visited us.
What just happened?
Some sort of ghost beard. Some weird guy said, "Watch out for the flames." Sometimes the NPCs in this game can be kind of weird.
And danger ahead? Why, that doesn't make any sense at all. The subjects have no connection to the evil. No one's seen any of their order in a long time. Perhaps we should take a look inside these. Now, please do be careful. Who knows what they're going to find?
Danger? What danger? Perhaps we should look inside these coffins. You know, nothing bad could ever happen. Sure, it'll be perfectly safe. Boom. Restless Draugr, which is actually a fairly difficult enemy for me, who's just level 3 at the moment. I am very low level, yeah, I just started, don't judge me, but anyway. I was able to manage him without too much difficulty. And did you kill Draugr back here by yourself? Maybe that was the one I roasted, I don't know. He wasn't very helpful. And he does have his oak flesh on. I guess I don't have any alteration spells yet, because alteration isn't on here yet. So, okay. But later on, you can use alteration spells to basically give you armor when you otherwise would have none wearing robes, which is always useful if you're doing close hand-to-hand combat kind of stuff. So we'll just heal up really quickly here. I'm only doing that because I want to be able to train my restoration a bit. It's going to be very helpful later on in the game. Okay, so Tolftir is being very slow. This video is probably going to be really long, but that's okay since it's like a preliminary episode. Most TV series, the pilot episodes are quite long, so... Yeah, I know, I get it. So there's going to be some more Draugr here, I believe. Boom. Not for long. You're dead. And just take them out. All regular Draugr, hopefully. I'm not very high level, so I can't deal with anything much better. Yeah, I'm kind of liking this whole casting stuff right now. It's working out pretty well. Petty soul gems. Draugrs do tend to drop, like, lots of jewels and soul gems. That's why I search every single one. I know their weapons and armor drops are really bad, but it's just mostly the soul gems and stuff that I'm after right now. So we need to find the danger within Sarthal. So Tolftir will kind of follow us. Yeah, I know! Leave me alone, dude. I'm just trying to do this quest. So now we go into Sarthal. I guess we weren't in Sarthal enough yet, so now we're officially in Sarthal. Yay! Level 3. I really hate the low levels when you're just completely weak and powerless, and the loot is all really bad. In some games it's fun to be low level, not in Skyrim. Just because with the way the perks are set up, the game becomes much easier to play once you're a higher level, even though you're fighting more difficult enemies. It's just very difficult to do much at a low level. Holy crap. What was that all about? I think I just set off some sort of trap there. And I am almost dead. So let's quickly heal up a bit. And I have no armor. And I have no Magicka. So what we're going to do is pop some potions. Minor Magicka. There we go. Switch to our flames. And these dragons don't stand a chance. So maybe I don't have quite enough Magicka. I was wrong when I said I was doing fine on the Magicka earlier. That apparently was not the case. I might have to buy some Magicka potions and healing potions and stuff, which I really didn't want to do, but I might have to do that anyway. So as long as he doesn't hit me, I'm good, but if he hits me like one more time, I'm dead. Oh, he's almost... Oh, here we... If you level up, I forgot about this, it gives you a free heal. And full Magicka, so we'll take that. And he's down for the count. So I should be getting pretty close to 25 destruction. The more I level up, the better it is, but yeah, we're gonna stick with these flames for now. And we'll switch to firebolt later on once I get that impact perk. If I'm struggling just with regular old Restless Draugr, I might really struggle with the boss of this dungeon. I don't have a follower yet. I was thinking about getting the follower in Riverwood when you first start the game. You can get a follower in a very easy quest in the first town you come across in the game. I was stupid and I didn't. I really should have. But I'll get a follower as soon as I can, and that's really going to help with keeping some of these Draugr off me. So, anyway, I think there's Draugr laying in the walls here, so I might try a few sneak attacks, just pull out the bow. Maybe not. One really good way to train sneak, though, when you're low level, oh, don't step on that, is when there's Draugr that are just laying in coffins along the wall, just sneak attack them. It trains your sneak very fast. Unfortunately, my sneak level is very low, and so these guys notice me. Even when you're wearing robes, because it's usually very easy to sneak in robes, because you're hard to detect, because you just don't make a lot of noise. If you're wearing, like, heavy armor, you're going to get noticed very easily, but normally when you're wearing robes, it's quite hard to detect you, but not in this case. And here we come across the very first puzzle of the game, and this one's very easy, because you see how it says a whale back there? You just have to set the pillar to a whale, and you're like, wow, even a two-year-old could figure that out. And while that's probably true, that's what they decided to do. They're warming you up with the easy puzzles, and later on in the game, the puzzles will still, unfortunately, remain very easy. But yeah, that's all it takes. Pull the lever, and we're through. And I think this dungeon is going to end pretty soon. Yeah, this is the part where I believe I have to fight a higher... leveled Draugr. So, I don't know if I'm going to come out of this alive, but we'll go for it. Might have to use potions liberally. Yeah, a Draugr white. This is not going to be fun. As long as I just try to avoid getting hit with that sword of his at all costs, it should be fine. Roast him a bit. Let's pop some potions. I really don't want to be using these potions so much, but I don't really have much of a choice. And we're almost out of Magicka, but he's almost dead, so we should be fine. Yep, we got him. So that was the first higher leveled enemy we fought in the game, and he was quite easy, but at the same time, he was a 2H guy, two-handed, which means, for one, he can do a ton of damage, but he's also quite easy to avoid. It's the guys that run really fast that you gotta watch out for. They're the scary ones. Or the archers. If he had a bow, I would have been screwed, I'll just be honest. Okay, let's proceed. I think I got everything I needed there. Oh, a chest. Another chest. Being pretty generous with the chest. Oh, I just picked up that hide armor by accident. I did not mean to do that. Get out of my life. Don't want that. And we are getting pretty close to the end of this. Oh! Shock trap. I don't like those. That scared me a bit. So, heal up. Not taking any chances here. And back to the flames. Oh my gosh. I keep getting hit with these shock traps. But here's another quote-unquote puzzle. It's again going to tell you the answers. This one's a little bit tricky though, because as you rotate the pillars, the other pillars will rotate as well. Like I rotate this one and that one rotates. There's a certain order that you do them in where they don't rotate, but I don't really know what it is. I'm not all that bothered, so that should do it. Nope, they're rotating on me a bit. Are we good now? Are we good? We're not good. Are you kidding me? Something rotated. I heard it. You are the culprit. Are we good now? Yeah, there we go. I'm not exactly sure how that puzzle works. I don't know the trick to it. But, we got it. Anyway, take that magic potion. That's helpful. Oh, Tolfdeer. You're back? To get shot with arrows? How long are these arrows lasting? Again, the lusty Argonian maid, really. This book is just everywhere. It's kind of a funny book if you actually read it, but I'm not gonna do that right now. That was like the most common book in Oblivion, I swear. And yeah. Another soldier first, and Tolfdeer stepped on that trap and set it off. I'm poisoned. Poison is just annoying because it kind of blurs your screen. Other than that, it's not that dangerous. So, oh my gosh, what is that? What could it be? What is that? Would you look at that? Yeah, I'm looking at it. I see it. And it's Gyric Galderson. What? No, I did not mean to do that. I need my flames out. But yeah, don't let him hit you. You can't damage him yet. But you just gotta wait for Tolfdeer to, I don't know, he does something with this big orb in the middle, and after he does that, you're able to damage the Draugr. So just heal up. There, now attack it. Okay, now we can kill him. Holy crap, he has a lot more health than I expected. Just, again, lucky thing with wearing robes is you're very light and you can move quite fast, so he's dead. That wasn't hard at all. He was quite a bit easier than the Dragowite. But Galder Amulet Fragment, that starts a quest of its own, which I will do later. But the Galder Amulet Fragment is actually a very, very good quest. I love that one. Yeah, Forbidden Legend. That is the quest that I'm referring to. One of my favorite quests in the game. Along with a quest later in the Mage's Guild. I'll stop calling it the Mage's Guild. It's hard. It's just habit, but... Okay, so... Now I believe we just talked to Tolfdeer, and that's the end of this quest.
To defend yourself.
What is this thing? Tell me what it is.
I have no idea. This is amazing.
Your lips are out of sync, dude. I wish I could move my lips and say things that my lips didn't say. Doesn't make any sense. I wish I could move my lips out of sync while talking in real life. That would be really funny. Just freak people out. Okay, so, yeah, we have to talk to the Archmage now. I was going to say I'm going to end the video off here, but what we can do, I believe we get like a reward chest at the end of this dungeon as well. Oh, a word wall, yeah. First word wall of the game. So even though I haven't killed any dragons yet, I don't have any dragon souls yet, I haven't done anything to do with the, main questline yet, I can still discover words, so that's what I did in that situation. Search the chest, and some crappy loot. But anyway, that's going to end off this video. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think, and yeah, stay tuned, and I'll continue the Mage's Guild, College of Winterhold, whatever, in a future episode. Farewell.